evening. Welcome to the first annual gala event meant to honor our Entrepreneur of the Year, Jack Schneider, and our Alum Entrepreneur of the Year, Joe Reynolds. We're very excited to have put on this event along with Kingston Financial, and we're very, very excited to honor these very deserving people. I'll talk with you just a second about what the Mean Center is and what we're trying to accomplish. And to do that, I think I would like to go to our mission statement, which is to graduate great entrepreneurship students, encourage them to start new businesses, and then support them through mentoring, networking, and funding.
What we try to do in the classroom is give students the abstract knowledge they need, how to do certain things to open a business. But in the Mean Center, we try to give them the opportunity to actually put that into practice. To look at a student who wants to create something, but they don't quite know how to go about it, and to watch that student get into the accelerator and go out and actually do things that move that business forward, that's a sense of accomplishment that's different from doing well in class. It's a different look at the world of business. It's more tangible, it's messier, it's more hands-on. And to watch their eyes light up when they've done something really important and really adult, business adult type, it's nice to see. It's really, really nice to see.
Well, I think when you look at the Mean Center and organizations like the Mean Center, you see the opportunity for young people to start coming up in an area of entrepreneurship. And when you look at entrepreneurs and what they mean to this country, 50% of the jobs that are created are done through entrepreneurs. So when you drive around McLean County, when you see the things that the two gentlemen, one in particular that we're honoring tonight, has done here, and of course Mr. Reynolds that he's done in Chicago, they build these communities, and the jobs that come from it and all the development that comes around it is just, it's unimaginable what a community would look like without entrepreneurs. So I think when you have the Mean Center, what they've done with these students and how they're bringing up that next generation, it's very, very important to have that as at the forefront of every community.
Well, we were looking for a way to support the College of Business. I'm an Illinois State College of Business graduate. And we thought of this idea. We've seen it done in some other communities where they have an Entrepreneur of the Year recognition dinner. So we approached Norris Porter at the College of Business in his development role. And it was just kind of a perfect fit for us because we really wanted to help connect the college with the community. We have a lot of friends and clients that are entrepreneurs and business owners locally. We just thought it was an ideal way to involve the college with the community, maybe get local businesses more involved in supporting the college, get the college involved with what businesses do locally and how they function. And there's just so many great students that come out of Illinois State College of Business. What a great thing for education of students, and what a great thing for the community. So we're just very pleased to be a partner with the College of Business and particularly the Mean Center in sponsoring this Entrepreneur of the Year dinner.
Coming tonight. I'm John Rudy from Kingston Wealth Management. It's a pleasure to have such a group at the first inaugural event for the Entrepreneur of the Year Award and the Georgia Martha Mean Center. You know, about 40 years ago, out in Oregon, there was a guy who was having breakfast one morning, and And he looked across the table and he looked at the waffle machine and he thought, you know, this kind of a pattern might make some sense to create a shoe that might make my track team run a little faster. So he tried a few things, a little trial and error. And after a little short time and a great partner, a company called Nike was born. Today, that company generates about $30 billion in sales. So you want to talk about the importance of entrepreneurs, that's it right there. It starts with an idea. It's about being creative. It's about taking risk. And it's about not being afraid to fail. It's interesting when you look at people across the world. Walt Disney was told in his first job at the Kansas City Star that he didn't have the right amount of creative ideas to make it in this world, and he was fired. Oprah Winfrey was told that she got too absorbed in her own stories and too emotionally connected, and she lost her job. Thomas Edison was viewed as being a guy who wasn't too bright, and man, maybe you'll make it, maybe you won't. So I think for the students that are here tonight, one of the things that you'll see from our two award winners, Jack Snyder, Joe Reynolds, you'll see guys that have mimicked and absolutely done the kind of things that it takes to be successful. So we're so pleased to be part of this and to have so many people here for the first year. It's just incredible. I'm going to put my glasses on now because I got to read a few things here. One of the things we want to be careful about tonight is time. I think the other component about being a good entrepreneur is managing people's time. So we're going to move along tonight quickly but nicely. I do want to take a few minutes out to thank some folks. You know, about a year ago when we started this idea, a friend of mine, Dave Wample, who's the president of Bloomington Normal Community Bank, was in a meeting with me, and we were talking about this, and he said, well, we'll jump on board as a presenting sponsor. Katie Gossman also was in a phone conversation with us, and her company, Commuter Ads, decided that they would also be a sponsor for the Alumni Award. So certainly thank them and all our award winners. Tonight we'll have a lot of the names up on the board. They'll be in your brochure as well. Events like this, for anybody who's been to them, you can't do it without a lot of support and a lot of volunteers. And I have to single out Mark Horsch's wife, Sharon. Sharon's just done a remarkable job. Anytime you have an event like this, you can probably count on the fact that it's going to be a woman behind the scenes who's doing all the work. So Sharon, wherever you are, thank you so much. Raise your hand. Where are you at, Sharon? She's probably working. Just a great job. I want to recognize some folks that are here tonight. We've got the ISU trustees, Bob Dobsky, and the student trustee, Ryan Powers. Both, thank you very much for being here tonight, Bob. Thanks. College of Business Advisory Council members, Julie Dobsky, Jared Hall, and Chris Lutt are all here tonight. And thank you folks for all, you know, these people do a lot of work with the university. It's just fantastic. State Representative Dan Brady. Dan, where are you at? Thanks for coming. Dan shows up at so many. Dan, if the crowd wasn't so young, I'd say you cover more territory than a Fuller Brush man with 9 kids, but most of these kids don't know what a Fuller Brush man is, but Dan shows up at everything, so thank you so much. Also want to thank the Means Center Advisory Board, Corey Farringle, Katie Gossman, who I mentioned, Kevin Kingston, also my partner from Kingston Wealth Management, and Ryan Fiala from DP Dose here as well tonight. Want to thank the ISU leadership tonight, and it starts with the new dean, A.J. Saman, who will speak tonight. A.J., welcome to the community. I know everybody has said how much you support entrepreneurial studies, and we're thrilled to have you here. Thank you. I want to also recognize Greg Ault in finance and planning, Tim Longfellow, and Alice Berkola, who are here from the university tonight. A lot of support from the university, and we really appreciate that. Folks, we're going to start dinner here right now. Once we get through part of it, when we get to the dessert, I'll come back up. I'll introduce Mark Holscher. We'll get the evening going. Thanks so much again for coming. It's so important. In my words earlier tonight, I talked about the importance of entrepreneurs in this country. When you talk about the amount of employment that comes from these folks, 50% of the people that are working in this country are because of what entrepreneurs do. So without them, I don't know where this country or this world would be. So thanks for coming. Enjoy dinner. We'll be back shortly.
Welcome, everyone. It's so exciting to see everyone come to our party, and I just deeply, deeply appreciate it. I hope everyone really enjoyed seeing all our contestants. We have them all out in the audience, fine young men and women, and we're so very proud of them. Very important to know that our startup showcase begins tomorrow at 8 a.m. I have to look at my beautiful wife. She is here now, by the way. She's the one that holds it together. Someone said Mark's in charge. Mark's not in charge. I just wanted you to know that. Very quickly, I want to give you a quick history of the Mean Center, and then look around and just think about how special it is that we're here today with the special partners that we have in the audience, and I'm deeply, deeply appreciative of it. So in 1997, the Institute for Entrepreneurial Studies was born, and that really is the beginning of what has now become the Mean Center. We had no money, we ran on fumes, but we had a dream, and I wasn't actually a part of that dream yet until 2002. In 2002, I was hired as a professor at, or as an assistant professor at Illinois State University. And I remember looking at the gentleman that was hiring me and I said, John, if you want me to run this institute, don't hire me. I want to be a professor. And if you want me to raise money, don't hire me. I want to be a professor. Well, don't ever tempt fate like that, because in 2005, I came on as director of the Institute for Entrepreneurial Studies. And again, we steadily grew. Our budget was $50,000 around that time, supported mostly by grant funding. And in 2010, in November of 2010, through the very hard work of many people, some of which are still in this room, many who have come before us, we got a death bequest of $5 million, and we became the George R. and Martha Mean Center for Entrepreneurial Studies. And our budget was about $160,000. We spent about $100,000 of it the first year or two and got our feet on the ground. Since then, we have had steady, steady growth. And I'm so very proud to be here in front of you and see what you participate in and what we as a community have made. Right now, our budget's right around $200,000. Our programs, Startup Showcase tomorrow. I hope that you all have the wonderful opportunity to explore and enjoy that. You have them amongst you, and they're wonderful, wonderful young men and women. We have our Mean Center Accelerator Program, and my associate director, Dr. Terry Knoll, will come up in just a moment and talk about that a little bit. We have our ISU Common Fellows, and tomorrow you will see them. They spread out all across campus, and they are responsible for the fact that we represent four of the seven colleges in the family of Illinois State University, the College of Applied Science and Technology, the College of Arts and Sciences, the College of Fine Arts, and the College of Business. So we have really had a reach, thanks to the generosity of many of you in this room. And then, of course, we have our public-private partnerships. We encourage you to look at that card, and Dr. Knoll will tell you a little bit more about that, and become a mentor in our group. We have Slingshot Co-Work, which we're so very proud of, and we're partners in that. That is something that we are partners in. It's a private effort through the hard work of many folks, but Mike Summers leads that charge. We are involved with the Being Angel Investor Network, and it's an embryonic network, but we have our students actually present there to get some of our accelerator money. And we're working towards incubators where we can place our students in St. Louis and Chicago. And Dr. Turnell can tell you a little bit more about that as well. With that being said, we're grateful that you're here. We're thankful. And I hope that you continue to have a wonderful evening. And now, I'm supposed to, it was with great pride I introduce our Associate Director, Dr. Terry Knoll.
Greetings, the student businesses you see this evening will be competing tomorrow in our Startup Showcase. That is a once-a-year event, and I'd like to tell you about ways in which we support our student entrepreneurs year-round. The Means Accelerator was started in order to provide a year-round support. So it started in January of this year. We have a threefold mission. The first is to provide financial support. The second is to provide in-kind services and support. And the third is to provide mentorship for our students. And while we're always grateful for the donors that make possible our first two, I'm here tonight to talk to you about the third and what in some ways is the most important, and that is our mentorship. Our students are going to succeed more likely if they have guidance, someone to show them the way because they've been there before, and to help them navigate the stormy seas of early stage startups. So our mentorship program is designed to have people like you who are accomplished business people to guide and support our students in an advisory capacity. And we take this relationship very seriously. And we're looking for competent, trustworthy, and people and those who are willing to commit to a long-term advisory relationship with our students. Now, if you would, please turn your attention to your place, and you will have seen a card that looks like this. And attached to this, you will see my business card. If you would like for me to contact you about the possibility of becoming a Means Center mentor, just remove my business card and clip your own to it and leave that card at the table. We will gather that before the tables are cleared at the end of the program tonight. If for some reason you do not have a business card with you, just pull my card off for reference, and then you can fill in the information on the card and we'll get in touch with you that way if you'd like us to. So if you'll take a moment to do that. Recently, the College of Business conducted a dean search. This process is always fraught with peril. Just between you and me, sometimes the dean you interview isn't the dean you get. My fears were allayed completely the first time I talked to our new dean. He listens intently, he treats everyone with courtesy, and he handles extremely difficult situations always with an eye toward fairness and what is good for the College of Business as a whole. It is my great pleasure to introduce to you tonight the Dean of the College of Business at Illinois State University, Dr. A.J. Sumant.
Chicago land, and it feels like coming home. We miss the changes in the season. We miss the colors of the fall, and sometimes we even miss snow, believe it or not. So it's a pleasure to be here. Illinois State University is an outstanding university. This is a wonderful community. The College of Business is a great place, and each day I'm glad I made the decision to move here. We have many points of pride in the College of Business, and one of the things we are very proud of is our Means Entrepreneurship Center. What we try to do is to give our students a portfolio of learning opportunities inside the classroom and outside it. In the classroom, we give our students cutting-edge curriculum, and outside the classroom, we try to give them opportunities for internships, for service learning with nonprofits, for study abroad opportunities, and entrepreneurial opportunities. So this forum is very, very important to us. I want to thank you, all of you, for your support of our endeavors. And I want to thank you for gracing this occasion with your presence. It is now my pleasure to introduce to you Kevin Kingston. As President and CEO, Kevin is responsible for the vision, for the leadership, and for the team development of his firm, Kingston Wealth Management Group. Kevin's extensive background of business management and financial planning for clients makes him uniquely qualified to work with clients' professional advisors in designing and implementing strategies to achieve their financial goals. Kevin attended the University of Illinois, received his business administration degree in 1976 from Illinois State University, and founded the Kingston Wealth Management Group. He completed the Chartered Financial Consultant and the Chartered Life Underwriter designations from the American College, and is a member of the Society of Finance Service Professionals. Having served on numerous boards in the community, Kevin currently serves on the board of the Westminster Village Foundation. He is a member of the Illinois State University 1857 Society and the Illinois Wesleyan University Associates. Kingston Wealth Management Group has partnered with the George and Martha Means Center for Entrepreneurial Studies at Illinois State University in founding the Entrepreneurship of the Year Award, which annually recognizes an outstanding entrepreneur in the community. Kevin enjoys scuba diving, golf, watching Illinois sports, and spending time along with his wife Jennifer and their daughters Chelsea and Taylor. It is my pleasure to welcome Kevin Kingston. Kevin.
And just want to thank all of you and my thanks for you attending tonight. We're delighted to have this kind of event on our first annual recognition dinner. And I was asked to talk a little bit about how this came about, so I'm going to give you hopefully a very brief description. We were talking about how our firm could connect with Illinois State University College of Business and really do something that would add some value to the college and most importantly the students. As far as I'm concerned, this event is really all about the students. I'm really pleased that Norris Porter got on board with us quickly when we talked with him about the idea of hosting a dinner like this to recognize not only an alumni individual who has been an entrepreneur, but also somebody in the Bloomington-Normal community. And when the group was meeting to talk about who that first individual should be, I've commented to Steve Snyder in Bloomington-Normal There's so many great entrepreneurs. We have so many friends and clients, the way John Rudy described earlier, that have made a difference in the community, that as far as I'm concerned, they make a difference in our country, just with ideas and things that they invent or develop. But you look at Bloomington Normal, it was hard to not think of somebody other than Jack Snyder, as you hopefully heard on the video. Steve commented that the Snyder companies and Jack may have been responsible for developing something like 20% of Bloomington Normal. So I mean, it's phenomenal when you look at what their companies and Jack have done. But as we were working towards this event tonight, Norris Porter had introduced us to Mark, and we were talking about Startup Showcase, and I think John Rudy and I, when we first heard about Startup Showcase, we're like, well, what's that all about? And then as we got involved a year ago, attended, and hopefully you had an opportunity to be in the room next door with students and their ideas. And I mean, it's exciting what's happened at the College of Business and particularly the George and Martha Mead Center. So thank you, gentlemen, for what you're doing with students. I mean, it's just a great time to celebrate this. I see it as kind of a win, most importantly for students. It's a win for business owners in the community to connect with students, and certainly a win for the college. So, Mark and Terry, really our hats off to you for, you know, what you've done with the Mean Center. I wanted to just comment also that as we celebrate this, it's kind of the first dinner on the front end of the Startup Showcase. It's just such a great fit. And just wanted to make you aware, I don't think anybody else mentioned it yet this evening, but next year, Steve and the Snyder Companies will be happy to know this event's going to be held at the DoubleTree in Bloomington. So thank you, Steve, for inviting us over there. And that, and the event is actually November 2nd, correct, Mark? Okay. So please plan to attend. We think. Okay, Sharon's correcting me. I'm glad I asked. John commented about Sharon earlier. She's done a great job behind the scenes, and she's commenting that the dinner's actually November 3rd. So mark your calendar for next year. By all means, get involved with the students tonight. And if you can come back, it's open tomorrow, right, Mark, to the public. Come in, come out anytime you can. I think you'll be impressed. If you didn't get a chance to visit the room next door with the students and what they've developed, tomorrow is such a great event. And if you can, come back anytime. You don't have to be here for the whole day. I was talking to some of our banker friends from Bloomington Normal Community Bank. They reminded me with Veterans Day, the banks are closed, so we'll look forward to seeing some of them here tomorrow. I want to now introduce a video of our first recipient of the Alumni Entrepreneur of the Year, and that's Joe Reynolds. Joe is the founder and CEO of Red Frog Events. And I want to thank specifically Commuter Ads. I think John recognized them earlier. But as soon as we talked about the idea of this event and the dinner, thank you, Commuter Ads. They were on board very quickly and stepped up to partner with us for presenting this award to Joe Reynolds and Red Frog Events. Joe will be up in a little bit, but before we do that, we just want to show you a little video of Joe. Thank you.
I had a wonderful experience at ISU. I attended from 1999 to 2003. Went to the College of Business, majored in entrepreneurship, which was very fitting for what I ended up doing for my career. I was also part of Delta Sigma Pi professional business fraternity during my time there that had a really big impact on developing myself as a leader and skills that followed through with what I do today. I've been very entrepreneurial my whole life, and during my junior year at ISU, I started my first company as a little house painting company that focused primarily on exteriors of homes and worked primarily during the summer season. So I did that in the last two summers at ISU, and then after I graduated, I expanded the business a little bit, added a few crews, and shut down the business every winter to specifically pursue my passion for travel. And for 4 years after college, I would pick a different part of the world and go travel. So I've been fortunate to have traveled to many countries and almost every continent all over the world. After 4 years of that, I decided it was time to get a little more serious about what I would want to do for the rest of my life. And I was just watching the TV show The Amazing Race on CBS one day and was inspired by that and thought it really married my passions for travel. And if I could make a business out of it, my passion for business too. So I ended up creating an event called Great Urban Race, which was modeled after the TV show The Amazing Race. Did one event locally in Chicago, and it worked. And launched 7 more, and then the next year, 20, and then a new event in 2009, and the rest is history. Red Frog Events is now comprised of 4 primary divisions. First, festivals, which would include Firefly Music Festival, our largest event, which takes place every June in Dover, Delaware. And Sharemack Fest, the St. Patrick's Day Festival in Washington, D.C., and Chicago Beer Classic, the Craft Beer Festival on the grass of Soldier Field here in Chicago. Then we have Warrior Dash, which is a 5K obstacle course race that happens in about 24 markets throughout the U.S. and is on a tour during the primary event season. The third is Event Sprout, which is a ticketing platform that we originally created for ourselves internally. We use it for all of our own events. But about a year and a half ago, we turned it outward, and now we have other events that use our platform to sell tickets for their events. And then lastly, as of about a year and a half ago, we brought on board a food and beverage company that does everything from catering to alcohol management to food concessions. And through them, we brought on some NASCAR clients, some air show clients, and then specifically, they do our own events as well. It was a very simple start. It was me working by myself in my one-bedroom apartment in the Wicker Park neighborhood of Chicago, going back in 2007, and it was similar in 2008. In 2009, I brought on my brother-in-law, first Red Frog employee and current co-CEO with me, and we launched Warrior Dash that year. That really led to pretty explosive growth for us over the next two-year period, where we went from one race to 10 to many more and beyond, and really drove our growth very quickly. In 2012, we launched Firefly Music Festival and had a wonderful learning curve with that one. We got into the music industry a little naively, but we figured it out. That's a wonderful event for us. So we went from one employee to now we're at about 100 full-time employees. I see a very bright future for Red Frog. We have a lot in our pipeline right now that are looking very promising. We'll be venturing into a totally new area of the event world starting next year. We'll be making an announcement on that in December. I have 2 main tips for anybody looking to start their own business. First, figure out what your passion is and then follow it relentlessly. And once you know what it is, really go for it. And 2, do it. That's the hardest part. Starting your own business is difficult and scary in so many ways, but there needs to be a time when you just pull the trigger and go for it and don't look back. If you can get over that hump, you're well on your way already. I feel incredibly touched and honored to be winning this award. I admire so many other people who graduated from ISU, the businesses they've started. So I'm humbled to be chosen to win this award.
Thank you.
Thanks. In the fall of 2002, I went into somebody's office in Williams Hall to pitch an idea. The idea was to get an internship, but with a twist. The internship I proposed was an internship to work for myself. I had already started my own company, my first company, a little house painting company called College West Painting. Somehow, my memories are a little fuzzy, I don't remember who I talked to, but somehow they approved it. As far as I can remember, I was allowed to grade myself on the internship because technically I was my own boss. And that ended up being one of the few A's I got here at ISU. But in all seriousness, my experience here was very meaningful because of situations like that. The faculty and the professors got it. They got that you could learn the basics in the classroom, and that was really important, but the real world and learning outside of the classroom was where the real lessons would come, and they gave me the freedom to be able to go do that. Later that year, I remember sitting down with Dr. Winchell to talk over my business plan for my senior year, and it was an idea for a fractional jet ownership company, a company that was way beyond what I would be able to do at age 22. But I remember Dr. Winchell not criticizing that it was way beyond what I should be able to do, but rather looking at me and encouraging me for dreaming big. And that really stuck with me to this day. And in fact, dream big is a part of our principles at Red Frog now, and one of our actual Red Frog ways to dream big. That's something that's followed me ever since my days here at ISU. On the personal side, I'm fortunate to have met my wife, Casey, who is also an ISU grad, also from the entrepreneurship program, and also from Delta Sigma Pi business fraternity. We were in together, and she's been my biggest champion through the whole Red Frog journey. Also, my sister-in-law, Kaylee, is here tonight. She's getting ready to graduate with a marketing degree from here next month. And my parents are here tonight, too. They taught me two key lessons that I think helped me on my whole journey through Red Frog the last 10 years. First, work hard, and not just hard, but like actually work really, really hard. I witnessed that through them as a kid, and it's something I hope to pass on to my kids, too. Secondly, they taught me to do good with whatever I do. So I'm really proud you saw in the video there tonight. We've now raised over $13.5 million for St. Jude Children's Research Hospital, something I'm personally very proud of. But the way I look at Red Frog now is as a vehicle for me to do good for the rest of my life. So hopefully $13.5 million raised for St. Jude is just a start for us. My parents also didn't totally agree with everything. I'm a little bit of a black sheep in my family. I'm very entrepreneurial spirited. I'm very risk tolerant, and my parents are the opposite of that. So when I told them at age 26 or 27 about my idea to start Red Frog Events, I think I about gave them a heart attack. In fact, my dad had a heart attack 2 weeks after. He's here right now, he's laughing, but that's a true story. But my parents were a big part of teaching me the skills I needed to run Red Frog. So thank you. This award's great. It's really cool to be a part of the very first one here tonight, and I'm really honored with all the incredible students coming out of ISU to even be considered for something like this. So thank you.
Jack will be our entrepreneur of the year. I'm Steve Snyder. I'm the son of Jack Snyder, the person that's being recognized tonight as Entrepreneur of the Year. Because of the great things he has done for our community over the last, well, he started when he was 18 and he's 87 now. So he's had quite a lifetime of achievements through the community, and he's developed about 20% of Bloomington Normal. He and my mother got married at a very young age. He was 18, she was 17. Didn't have a penny to his name and was working a little bit for his father. One day a gentleman approached him and says, I will guarantee you $10,000 if I can develop the property behind you and buy it from you. So my father thought about it for a while and thought, well, I can develop that property. So my father went to the bank. He still needed money for equipment and everything and materials for the project. And instead of making $10,000 on the project, he made $50,000. He found something he could do and that he could do well. And then the rest is kind of history. After that project, he actually got into the insurance business. Jack was very involved in insurance at Bloomington Normal, had one of the largest agencies in town. The development side, the real estate side, the home building side was always kind of a hobby for him. Obviously, over the years, it became a major part of our business. We still have the insurance division, we have the insurance or the real estate company, and so we keep moving forward with new projects and new things. I think we have about 28 different companies. Basically, it started with the insurance company, then we went into the real estate division. We started doing subdivisions. We've done several hotels in Bloomington Normal and in Champaign-Urbana. We have developed property in Florida, condominiums down in the Sarasota area. We have about 1,800 apartment units. We have some small strip centers, and about we currently have about 11 different subdivisions. And I think over the years we've developed probably a total of 20. For the entire family, it's something that we want to give back to the community. The community has been very good to us. And so my father developed a foundation several years ago. And from the foundation, we donate to different entities throughout the community, becoming a very substantial foundation, and we're able to do a lot in the area. So it's kind of exciting just to be able to give back the way we are. My father has dementia. And it's kind of sad because a lot of his friends over the years have passed on, and now with his issues, it's just sad to watch. You know, I stop over at his house quite often, and my sisters do also, and whenever we go in there, he has that smile on his face, and he's just always very happy to see us, even though his memory isn't what it used to be. But he has been just, you know, a main figure in the community, and he had a lot of help from a lot of people in the community to get where he is today. And the people in Bloomington Normal had a lot of faith in him to accomplish what he said he would accomplish. If you have a dream, as he did, if you have that dream, that passion, you know, get that fire in your belly and go out there and try and accomplish what you want to get done.
He's about
Arnold to town. Surely he could put me in touch with Arnold, and Arnold will just fly in, and we'll have a golf event. Everything will be wonderful. So I called Jack and sat down with him in his office and told him why I was there. I said, Jack, I really am here just to ask for your help. And I think he appreciated the candidness and the honesty. And when I asked him, his response was, I said, Jack, we'd like to have this golf event. I know you're connected to Arnold, you bought him a town, developed a golf course, wonderful things for the community. But we'd like to have him come participate in a golf event. And, you know, it's almost naive to think that that's going to happen, right? But Jack goes, well, Kevin, I'll tell you, when I had Arnold Palmer come to town, what I had to do was deposit $350,000, I think, Steve, was the number to his bank account. And as you saw in that video, one of the things I love about Jack, he has a great laugh, and we laughed hard after he told me. And I'm quickly realizing, well, this isn't going to happen, but it was a lot of fun. We had a fun time and a good laugh with Jack. I want to just comment, as you saw from that video, I thought it was a terrific video. Mark, you guys, you know, your videographer just has done a great job, so thank you. But I wanted to comment, as you saw from that video, Jack Snyder, as an entrepreneur and business person, in my mind, he not only developed a great business, but Jack developed a great family. And I've gotten to know Steve and his wife, Nancy, over the years. And I'm just getting to meet, to know Jack's daughters. And I have the privilege of introducing Steve. Steve's here tonight with his family to accept this award on Jack's behalf. Steve, like his father, is an entrepreneur. And after Steve completed a business degree at Colorado State University, Steve actually started the real estate company that we were kind of seeing maybe bits of. It's now known in Bloomington as Berkshire Hathaway Snyder. And they're one of the largest sales forces in the area, as many of you know. But under Steve's leadership, Snyder Development continues to be one of the major developers in Central Illinois. And Steve and Nancy, as many of you know, are very active in various numerous community activities, charitable organizations. Steve and Nancy have four adult children. And I know in talking with Steve periodically that one of their greatest joys is their two grandchildren. So please join me. Nancy is here with Steve, but please welcome Steve Snyder to the stage to accept the award for Jack.
I'm very honored to be accepting this on behalf of the family. As Kevin mentioned, several of my family members are here. I'd like for my sisters to stand up. My sister Vicki I, she flew in from Minnesota today. We're part of her family. And also Susan Cheney. Especially my daughter, I don't see her very often, so she came in from St. Louis today. So that's Christine, by the way. Very proud of her, too. You know, my father would be very humbled by this. You know, he would never consider himself an entrepreneur. what his passion was. When he got married to my mother, as I mentioned in the video, he was 18, she was 17. Very soon after, when they were married, there was my older sister on the way, Susan. And my father realized that he had to provide for his family. And providing for his family was his passion. He joked with my mom that he never wanted something to happen to him, or he had to have her wait tables the rest of her life. And he saw to it that that would never happen. Our entire family is so proud of him, and could not be more pleased with what he's done for ourselves and our community. As I mentioned earlier, with the golf courses and the apartments and everything else he has developed, it's about 20% of the area. And a lot of entrepreneurs around the room I see here, and the young people that we saw earlier, you know, if you have that passion, if you have a dream, if you know there's something out there, don't be afraid to fail. Not everything my father did worked. Some, I'm still cleaning up the messes. But the ones that work turn out amazing. So just, if you have that drive and you want to do it, you know, just pursue it. If you need help, don't be afraid to ask. Go to people. My father needed help early on. He lacked the funds to do certain things. He approached people and said, hey, can you help me out do this? I'll pay you as I sell lots. And they went along with him. So if you have that dream, do it. And I wish I was going to be in town where I'd love to have a chance to see more of the showcase next door, but I have to leave in the morning, but we'll be able to see it. But the people involved in the showcase, you know, do the best you can. I know from the past, some of you have appeared on Shark Tank, or some of the older members have, so that's exciting. A lot of things going on. So it's great that we have the Mean Center here in town for entrepreneurial leadership, and it's great. So thank you so much.
So I feel a little bit better to be able to know who I'm kind of handing things off to. So you'll get to know Liz. Joe and Jack, what a great way to start. Joe, I remember in 2008 when I was new to the development gig and you and I had a beer at Goose Island Brewery, and he was just launching the business. And then I convinced you to bring the Great Urban Race to Homecoming 2 years, and then you met Casey. And now you have 2 children, one on the way, so I'm just like, wow, I'm old, right? Things like this wouldn't happen without involvement in the community, and so it's really good to see a lot of business leaders, entrepreneurs, and as Terry mentioned earlier, if people don't get involved, the next generation doesn't develop, and that takes personal time and investment, it takes financial resources. So we're very thankful for those that partnered and that attended the event. And if you want to find other ways to get involved with the college and the Mead Center, reach out, let me know. I'm happy to talk to you and we'll get you connected. But I want you to look at the program, and I just want to go through the sponsors tonight. The presenting partner award, Bloomington Normal Community Bank, the alumni award partner, Commuter Ads, we very much appreciate that. We have Great Plains Media and Cities 92.9, Row Construction, WJBC, and Humulus Radio. I hadn't been on the radio before, and John says, guess what, we're gonna be on the radio. I'm like, okay, new gig, we'll try it. Worked okay. ADM, Chase, Commerce Bank, the Pantagraph, Snyder Companies, the Town of Normal, and with the Town of Normal, when you leave the parking garage tonight, the gates should be up, so you won't have to pay on the way out, so thanks to the Town of Normal. Distill for providing the beer for us during the cocktail hour, we're much appreciated, and Kingston Wolf Management Group. As you walked in, you saw the banners of Joe and Jack. So imagine 10, 12 years from now, we're gonna have banners going all the way around the room so that every year we can see those individuals that have made an impact and a difference. So thank you very much. We hope to see you tomorrow and definitely next year at this event. One more thing, I guess, for Mark.
If you park in the uptown station lot, I have tickets that will get you out for free.
Yeah, if you park in the uptown station garage, see Mark or Sharon, and they'll give you a voucher so you can get out. So thank you very much. Have a great evening. One last thing. If you're an active service military or a veteran, would you please stand? Do we have any veterans? We very much appreciate your service. It's something that's near and dear to me. I have a son in the Seabees in the Navy, so we appreciate your service. Good night, and thank you again.